Are you a business owner slash parent? Well, today we are talking about how to have the energy, the mindset, and more to do both.
Welcome to Blare Radio, where every brand can be heard. Now, the voice behind the mic, James Shannon.
Welcome to Blare Radio. Start your business and be heard. I wanted to drop episode 12 now because today's guest has a birthday in 2 days on March 11th. So I want to wish today's guest, Dustin Hill, a very happy birthday. Also, Dustin's course is at a very generous price right now, and I wanted all of you to have an opportunity to get in before the price jumps. Even if you missed this very special introductory offer, you can still visit his website, parentsuccessplan.com, and sign up today. Dustin is an amazing person, and I just wanted to make sure that you knew what he was offering to you. All right, moms and dads, parenting is hard. We all know that. It's tiresome. It's exhausting. And when I started my business, I was working a day job at the same time, and it really made it difficult to be happy at home. It even played a role in me and my fiance breaking up at the time. Today, we are going to talk about how you can be happy at home and at work at the same time. Also, at the time of this recording, my family and I, we were dealing with a very tough issue, and I honestly can't get into it right now, but I had to find a way to be strong for them and continue to do what I do, which is this podcast. Today's guest and I, we both have 4 kids, and if he knew a way to help me with being a dad, then I wanted to listen. And right now, I want you to listen. Today's guest is on a mission to help 10 million parents have more success and less stress. He can help you recharge, work on your mindset, and level up. He is Dustin Hill from parentsuccess.com. Dustin, I'm so excited to have you on the show today, and I can't wait to learn more about getting into the right mindset. But first, I want to know about you. When you were a kid, what did you want to be?
Yeah, hey, that's a good question, James, and thank you so much for having me. You know, so, yeah, I think as a kid, you know, I mean, one of my first dreams was to be like an NBA basketball player. You know, I'd see like the kids on the court after the game, and I was like, oh man, that'd be so cool. I could love to do that. So I played a lot of basketball growing up. I mean, I didn't really stick to it. You know, in high school, I ended up switching over to more like music. I play the drums and stuff like that. And so anyways, kind of switched around with some of that. But, and you know, as I got a little bit more serious about it, I realized that I love like science and math. And so I went into engineering. And now I do, you know, software engineering full time, but I'm also on a mission to help parents, like you said. So that's kind of where I'm at now. And yeah, so it's a fun place to be.
I wish I was just a little bit taller so I can play basketball. All right. So you're helping parents. Are you a parent yourself?
Yeah, I am. So I'm a dad of 4 kids. They're all under 8 currently. And a lot of people are like, oh man, how do you do that? Like, I don't know. I can hardly do it with 1 or 2, you know, but, and I know you have 4 kids as well. And so, you know, I've got a girl and 3 boys and yeah, it's definitely a lot of fun. It definitely is challenging as well, as you know, and many of your listeners know as well. But it's, you know, it's one of those things that I think like, as I've just really found a huge transformation of myself, like that as I take care of myself, as I work on my mindset, you know, and I have better like goals for what I want to achieve at home, then like it's just night and day how different it is, you know, to come home and have a lot more energy and joy and like just more confidence too, that like, hey, like I can make a change and I can be better. And also tackle everything else in my life as well. Cause that's a, you know, one thing that a lot of us struggle with is like, well, how do I like, do I have to choose, right? Can I only really be successful in one? But no, you totally can. And so that's why I'm like really trying to push for, you know, helping parents in this way.
And I thank you for that. Just like you mentioned, I do have 4 kids. I have 3 daughters and 1 baby boy. And I've always struggled with this issue. I would go to my day job, I would come home, and I would never have the energy that I wanted to have to play with my kids. So how do we find this energy that we're missing?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great question. And there's, you know, there's a lot of ways to do it. And it kind of does depend a little bit on the person. But one thing that is pretty universal is taking care of your body. You know, so obviously nutrition's important. You know, if you're not giving your body the nutrients it needs, then it just naturally is not going to be like functioning at a high level. Another thing is movement as well. So, you know, whether that's exercising, whether that's, you know, just making like doing some stretching and things like that. But like really your body, as you do take care of it, then it actually is going to have more energy, which I always had, I struggled with a little bit because I used to like never be excited about working out or, you know, going on a walk or things like that. Because I was like, oh, like it just doesn't sound that good. And then it's like, well, I'm spending this time doing it, so I really have time for it. But it's like, honestly, I'm way more productive and I have so much more energy when I do that. Right. And so that's just one thing that really makes a big difference as well. And so, but like I mentioned, yeah, there's definitely a lot of other things. And one of the other things I would say that's a big piece of having energy is actually your mindset as well. Is, you know, for me, like you mentioned, like coming home and you're like, oh, like I used to come home, you know, find myself just sitting on the couch, like scrolling on my phone or whatever, just because I just felt like I just had given everything to my 9 to 5. And then I get home and I'm like, oh, I'm just tired. My kids are like coming up and they want me to play, but I just don't really have the energy to do it. You know, and really what helped me change that is partially my mindset, right? So partially just thinking about, okay, when I get home, came up with this mantra, which is like how I want to have my best behavior at home. And so as I would get home, I would be thinking about that. And so then it, you know, really allowed my brain to change how the next, you know, couple hours worked, right? It was like, okay, so rather than what used to happen is you'd get home and you'd just be tired, right? And a lot of times I tell myself that I'm tired too. So that's another, you know, downer. But now I'm thinking, oh yeah, I want my best behavior to be when I get home. So like I did have all this energy at work, right? And now I want this same energy at home. And so, you know, my brain's able to help me through that. You know, and so then it's that much easier to then have that energy while I'm at home. And so now, you know, not that no one's perfect, I'm not either, but you know, it really has helped me to have that, you know, extra boost of energy as I get home to be with my kids.
I'm glad you have that extra boost of energy, and I wish that for every parent in the world. I also read that you had your great family, but there was something that was missing. Can you tell us what that was?
Yeah, no, that's great. I mean, I felt like early on in my career, you know, I saw quite a bit of success. I was a mechanical engineer. That was my degree, but I really loved software and started doing that during college. And so that's where I ended up getting a job. I got a job at GM as a software engineer. And so, you know, that was one big success. And then I, you know, made this big policy change at GM. And then I was able to switch over to like mobile app development, which I was more excited about. And then I started leading a team. And this is all like within like 4 years. And I just felt like there was all this success that I was having there. But then I was looking at like my progress at home and like success and like my energy level at home. I just felt like it wasn't the same, right? I didn't see that like growth that I did in the workplace. But then isn't my happiness at home, isn't that like even more important than like it is at work, right? You know, and so it was just one of those things that I really realized like, yeah, this is like something is a little bit off here, right? I don't like, I want to obviously go to work and be successful there so I can take care of my family, but not at the expense of being the very best that I can be at home. And so that's what really kind of pushed me on this journey and has really helped me to figure out, okay, what is it that I need to do to change this? And, you know, and as I felt that change and that confidence, then I was like, man, I just like, I feel so much better, like 100% night and day difference that I need to share this. Right. And I knew that as I experienced that, I needed to change it. And so it's been, you know, it's been there's a lot of work that goes into doing this type of stuff to be able to help out parents, but it's been something really fulfilling too, just because I know the difference that it makes.
And I'm so happy that you are helping out so many parents. And speaking of success, you created the Parent Success Plan. What is the Parent Success Plan and how do I get one?
Yeah, no, that's a good question. Yeah. And so, I mean, the Parent Success Plan is a course which, you know, teaches about, you know, some of the concepts I've talked about. So like, how do you recharge? Like, what does that look like? How do you work on your mindset? And then how do you level up? So how do you actually, you know, take that action to change, whether that's changing your energy, changing your mindset, or just changing, you know, maybe it's other things in your life, you know, that could be at home, could be, you know, especially at home, but could actually also apply at work. And so yeah, but the idea of like kind of why I came up with that name is, you know, we talk about career plans all the time and career goals and all that type of stuff, but we don't really have anything at home, right? Like, what is that? And so that's kind of my idea is that, hey, let's take this for parents. Like, what is your success plan at home? Like, what do you actually want to accomplish? And what are the things that you want to be able to change? And so that's where the name comes from. And that's why I'm just, yeah, excited for it. Cause you know, again, we do a lot of times focus more on work when we converse with others and talk about things, but I want to put an emphasis on that, on the family, because that's really where, hey, if you're super successful in your career, but you're not at home, like, does that even matter as much, you know? So right. That's why I'm excited to share that.
Yes. No matter how well I do at anything, it's not going to matter if I'm not successful at home as a parent. And I'm sure you can agree, family is everything.
Yeah, for sure.
And I don't want to give too much away, but you have the top 20 ways to recharge as a parent. Are you able to share maybe one or two of them?
Yeah, for sure. Happy to share that. Yeah, so I mentioned a couple of them. You know, walk is one of them that I really like to do. Another one is to do yoga. So there's a lot of people that like to do yoga. If you don't, or if you haven't actually tried it, I would say just try it, because that was something that my wife was always like, oh, hey, you should try this with me. And I never really wanted to. But finally, when I did, I was like, oh, wow, that actually was a pretty good workout. And I also like felt like relaxed, you know? And so that's another one of those. Another one is to meditate or to pray. So if you believe in God, I think prayer can definitely help. But also just like meditating and really thinking through some of the things that you're blessed, you know, that you're grateful for. And that's actually another one. So like, you know, a couple bonus ones is to write down what you're grateful for. It's not, you know, an activity necessarily as far as like for your body, but it's really, really helpful for your mind though, to think about, oh, wow, like, yeah, I'm so blessed because of these different things. And you know, thinking about the things that we do have can really help us to want more of that and more of some other things, rather than, you know, thinking about the things that we don't have. Because if you always think about things we don't have, then you tend to not ever get those things.
Yeah. I mean, I do pray, and every once in a while I'll write down something that I'm grateful for. I still need to walk some more. And my daughter is trying to get me to get into yoga. Maybe I will eventually, but no.
Yeah. Those are great. Yeah. You should do it, man.
I want to talk more about mindset and what ways, or what can we do to get into the right mindset?
Yeah, I'm super happy to talk about this. And, you know, it's so one of the biggest things with mindset is I like to talk about limiting beliefs. And so, you know, for those of you that may not understand what that means, you know, it's just like, think about something that you've thought about, you know, maybe recently, it could be even growing up, that is kind of holding you back, right? So for instance, one thing that I hear a lot from parents is, I don't have time. You know, and I've dealt with this too. I remember, especially with our third kid, I just remember I knew about the whole newborn phase. I knew all about that. And so I was like, oh, I'm not going to have time. So I need to do all these things. Right. And sure, you know, the newborn phase is not a great example, because it is definitely a busy time. But you know, if you continue to think that you don't have time, then that's just like, that's kind of that limiting belief that like, oh, I can't do it. Right. I can't do this or this or this because I just don't have time. And, you know, and so that's kind of the first step is, you know, recognizing what is something that's holding you back. And maybe it's time, maybe it's, you know, patience, whatever it is. But really, really trying to think about what is that that's holding you back. And then the next step of that is to, you know, understand why is it important for you to change this, right? It's like, you know, with time, it would be, well, because I want to be able to get more done, right? I want to be able to enjoy this time that I'm spending with my kids and, you know, working on my business or whatever it is. So really getting some emotion behind that, because then that can really help you make the change. And so then the next step is to really look at what is the new belief that you want to have. So, you know, if it's, I don't have time, then you need to rephrase that. And, you know, typically writing it down is a great idea. You know, something like, you know, I create time for what's most important, or, you know, whatever it is. So now you can like start trying to shift that and try to actually, you know, make a change in that way. And so once you have that written down, then it's, you know, important to just be thinking about it, you know, often. So, you know, think about it throughout the day, think about it at night, you know, and having it written down somewhere where you can see it. Maybe it's a note on your phone, or maybe it's somewhere visible. But continue to think through that. And as you do, you'll start to notice that, wow, yeah, actually, like, I'm starting to change this process, you know. And that's where also, like, you know, a coach can come involved too, or you can really like help you to remember the things that you're trying to accomplish. But yeah. And what what I think is really important is just to like, to start somewhere, right? Sometimes we think like, oh, I got to do this like perfect thing and I'm not exactly sure what to do. But, you know, just starting somewhere is really good. And what I also wanted to say too, is that, you know, with these beliefs, like if it's, you know, if you really that second piece of like getting the emotion behind it of why you want to do it, like if you can really own in on that, then everything else kind of works. Like you almost don't even need to write it down sometimes because it's so ingrained into you. You're like, oh yes, like this is what I have to change. And I really want to change this. Then it's just, it becomes part of you and it makes it that much easier to actually change.
It doesn't cost anything but a moment of your time to write down whatever your limiting beliefs are. Dustin, I want to move into your level up plan. Can you tell us more about it and what it is?
Yeah, that's a great question. So yeah, Level Up is a simply a powerful framework to actually make change in your life, you know? And so that's where it actually is a little bit of kind of what I walk through, but just in a more a general sense. And so really the first step of that is to understand the current level that you're at. Kind of like with limiting belief is like, okay, well, where am I right now? Like, let's just like kind of, you know, look at the playing field, like what's going on. So let's say, for instance, maybe you're like you occasionally yell at your kids or something. So that's something we want to change. And so it's like, okay, like right now I yell at my kids. Maybe it's like at night sometimes when they're going to bed. Like that's just like, it's frustrating. So that's happening. So you know, understand what the current level is and then, you know, think about what's the next level that you want to get on. And so in this case, it's like, well, you know, I actually want to stop yelling. I just don't feel like that's helping me. And similar to limiting beliefs, you know, then you also want to think about like, why is this so important? And so, you know, it's like, I don't feel good after I yell. Like I feel kind of guilty and my kids don't like it either. So it's like something I don't want to do. Right. And so you really kind of understand what the purpose is and then you commit to do it. So committing to doing it, you know, obviously it's really powerful for you to consciously think, oh yeah, like I'm going to do this. I'm going to make this change. It's actually also really beneficial as well to socialize that goal of, hey, this is what I'm doing. Like I'm going to stop yelling. And so helping those, and you know, I went through this same process when actually about yelling too. And it was something that I actually, you know, told my kids that this is what I was going to do, you know, and it made it that much more real in my brain. And for me that like, hey, I have to do this if I just told my kids that I'm going to do it. And then the last step is just to simply follow up. And so, you know, you want to come up with like a follow-up plan that makes sense for the level that you're working on. It may be a daily thing, weekly thing, but like having a place to check in. And then as you check in, you can really verify, did you make it to that next level? And then you're ready to go to the next level? Or is there something else that needs to happen? You know, and as you follow up, then you can figure out if let's say you're stuck there, you know, longer than you think, then you may need to revisit a little bit of like your tactics of how you're overcoming that. You know, maybe it's time to read a book or to get some help in that way. But really it's a way to like, as you follow up, then you'll actually be able to see that progress as well.
That's awesome, Dustin. I'm always looking for ways to get to that next level. There are things that as a parent I need to stop doing as well. There's also things that I want to do more of. So really helpful tips. So I know that you have this course and we covered recharging mindset and needing to level up. Is there anything else that we can get from the course or?
Yeah. So most of it, that's really is the basics of it, that it walks through, you know, these different concepts. And really one of the biggest, you know, pieces that it helps with as well is to actually give you the, like some worksheets to do it as well. So then you understand, okay, so like I can easily, you know, accomplish some of these things because I know that can be a challenge. And then I do have a couple bonuses as well that go with it. So there's like a communication video course. So how do you better communicate with those that you love, especially, but also like at work too, that may help. And then 30 days of motivation and encouragement. So just some things that you can listen to or and watch and like be encouraged in that way. And then the last one is 30 days to stick to any goal as well. And so it's, you know, really there's just this concept of, you know, sometimes we, you know, it's just hard to stick to something, right? But that's something that this will help with as well.
That's great. And that is a lot. I see that it's valued over $1,200. So why just 97?
Yeah, no, that's a good question. I mean, I think a lot of it's just, well, I want to give to parents, right? I mean, I know that it's, you know, parents need this type of stuff. And so, and part of that as well, it's just like introductory price. And so it probably will go up in the next little while, but just wanted to kind of do that just as I'm watching it to those that to get in there first.
So in other words, we better go and get it now, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So right now you are offering early access to your course. Is there a date set that price might jump up, or you don't know yet, or do we have to just find out?
Yeah. Well, originally I was just thinking like my birthday, which is March 11th. So it's coming up pretty soon, but we'll see, you know, we'll see when that changes. But
And how long is this course?
Yeah, so it is broken up into those different modules. So there's like an introductory module for you really understand like what do you want to accomplish, and then it breaks up into recharts. You can really kind of master those concepts, and then to mindset and leveling up, and then like a recap. So it's those five modules, and then the, you know, three bonuses.
Great, and I do have a question. So I know we've been talking a lot about parents, and those out there that are listening that don't have any children, are they able to benefit from this course, maybe just to get into the right mindset, or is it something that's strictly for parents only?
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, it's really the concepts, like it's less about parenting tactics, like, you know, how do you, you know, speak better to your kids or, you know, whatever. It's more about like the concepts of this and how does this apply. So it definitely does work. And my sister, when I was, you know, sharing with her some of these concepts, she's like, oh man, this is great for me too. I'm like, I want this. And so, yeah. So, and it's, yeah, part of it's just like trying to focus in on parents, just because I think that it's, you know, it's really helpful and it's helped me a lot. But yeah, the principles definitely apply to everybody.
And do you have any other ways that you're working on to try to reach 10 million parents?
Yeah, no, definitely got a long ways to go there, but I'm excited to make that happen. And, you know, one of the things I'm actually starting is to do challenges. And so something that I know a lot of parents and everybody struggles with is, you know, putting your phone down. And so I have a phone down challenge coming up pretty soon where, you know, I teach some of these concepts, but really help see like, oh, well, how do you actually like put down your phone so that you can connect more with your kids? Because it is like, sometimes it really just like when I go to a restaurant and I see, you know, how many people are there and they're not really there together. They're actually just like on their phones. And it's just like, it really like makes me sad sometimes, thinking like, oh man, like here's these two people that could be having a wonderful like time together, and yet they're just like on their phones, you know. And so like just really understanding like what are some of the ways that I can do that, how do I, you know, get the confidence that I can do that, kind of break away from that, and then actually just like have, you know, deepen those relationships that you have with those you care about.
Yeah, that would be a very tough challenge for me and for my kids. But you're right. I see the need for it. Everybody, not even just us, a lot of people out there have a very hard time communicating with each other because of their phones. So we mentioned the course. Where can we get it? Where can people listening find it?
Yeah. So, just go to parentsuccessplan.com. And that will actually give you the, you know, top 20 ways to recharge. And there's also a free like mini course that, you know, walks through a few different days of understanding some of these concepts. And then it will, you know, invite you to also join the course as well. But yeah, so, I mean, if you're ready to get that, then there's a link in there to go buy it, but you can also, you know, get that, those free resources as well.
Oh, that's great. Again, that is parentsuccessplan.com. Dustin, I do want to be mindful of your time. And just real quick before you go, you have any tips for parents? Is there anything that we haven't covered yet?
You know, I think the biggest thing I'd want to say is just that like you're doing a lot better than you probably think you are. You know, I think that I've seen a lot of parents that they feel like, oh man, like I just wish I could figure this thing out. Like I'm not sure what to do with, you know, my son or my daughter, or this thing's going on. And, you know, a lot of times they don't feel like the confidence that they can do it. And they, but I like always really like to remind them that like you're doing a lot better than you think that you are. You know, and sure, all of us always have things that we can improve, but just like the fact that you're here, that you're, you know, you care, that you're thinking about your kids and really trying to get better, then, you know, you're doing great. And so I think that's like just a really important thing, is just to continue to keep going. Cause if you give up, like that's the worst thing that can happen. So just always, you know, keep your head up and keep trying, and things will work out, and know that, you know, more joy and happiness is on your way.
I love that. Cause I always think that I can do better and I can be better. And just to being a parent is difficult. And we are always trying to find ways to get better, and for you to say that we are doing better than what we think, that means a lot. People that are interested to find out more about you or even to reach you, where can they find you?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, the best way is just to go to parentsuccessplan.com and then sign up for that free gift, and then you'll get an email, that free mini course, and then in the email, it'll actually have links to like social media. So, you know, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube. So all of those will just be there with easy links to go check it out. Definitely want to meet you guys. So definitely check it out.
Great. That is Dustin Hill from the parentsuccessplan.com on a mission to help 10 million parents across the globe. Dustin, I want to thank you so very much for joining me today, and I appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Dustin, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So Dustin and I scheduled a time to record, and I was an hour late due to a power outage in my area. Then to make matters worse, I have two phones, so I couldn't even get a hold of him because the one that had his contact information was missing. So I'm scrambling around trying to find my other phone so I can see how we can get this show recorded. But lucky for me, the outage was a short one, and Dustin was still able to bless us with his presence. So again, Dustin, I thank you for that. Like I said at the top of the show, my family had a situation that was on my mind during the entire interview. And once Dustin said, "You are doing a lot better than you probably think you are," I felt that. I felt like he was talking to me and to my daughter's mother. And that was really helpful. So I appreciate that as well. And I want to thank all of you for joining me today. For everyone listening, if you are interested, visit parentsuccessplan.com for Dustin's free mini course for less stress and more success at home. I will leave that link and more in the show notes at theblaregroup.com/EP12. And I just want to leave you with one last quote from Dustin. Well, if he didn't make it up, I got it from him. Don't forget, find joy in progress, not perfection. Do you ever have those moments when you're working so hard on your business and you forget to go shopping for dinner? Well, Instacart will deliver groceries whenever you need them for one monthly fee. Cool, right? I love that I can play with my kids or work on my business while I wait for as little as 1 hour for my groceries to be delivered from my favorite local stores. Visit theblaregroup.com/Instacart or go to the show notes of this episode to get started. And that link is an affiliate link, and I may receive a commission if you visit theblaregroup.com/Instacart. Thanks for the support, and be heard.
Thanks for listening to Blare Radio, where we turn your online whispers into screams. Learn more at theblaregroup.com. Until next time, be heard.